since we are inside M&T Bank Stadium near the Inner Harbor in Baltimore, Maryland. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Washington Football Team and the Baltimore Ravens. And this will make it into the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Takes over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
And the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. From the shotgun, it's Taylor, eluding the pressure right. Now he'll pull it down. And oh, right away, he lost the football. But Taylor, this will fortunately keeper, wind up out of bounds. Taylor able to use those legs of his to pick up a first. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. From the gun, it's Taylor. And a quick throw here, that's complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
It's a gain of 8.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them.
Touchdown, Washington! Out of the season. And Washington has taken a first quarter lead.
For the extra point.
If you did know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now, you can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of offense.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25.
The Ravens take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 24. And the former Heisman winner, this is Mark Ingram. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line.
He was tackled at
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
On second down, Ingram. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Jackson from the shotgun. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So much for the run on third and one. Instead, it's a big chunk in the pass game. First down. From the gun, it's Jackson. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's another first down as they look his way again, this time 19 yards.
First and 10 at the 28-yard line.
The gun, Jackson looking for the end zone, and this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me that's the magic number. 20 points score gives yourself, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace. Well, the gap man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
So, yes, it's only three, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there, because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things, because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
On the pickup, second and six.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. This time Taylor will throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. A free safety blitz, that can be a gamble, but it proves fruitful there.
Yeah, you're exactly right about the gamble, because oftentimes the free safety is the last line of defense against a long pass. And when he comes at the quarterback, he'd better get home and make the play. Otherwise, a big play could result for the offense.
Off the play fake, here's Taylor. He's going to fire one deep, middle. Oh, this is taken in, it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15. On first and 10, it's Taylor. Now they go screen, it's complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. This gain not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
Nice little nifty play for him there. That's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody covered. Oh, he just stuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Washington.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Out of the shotgun, Breida. And he'll get about three as he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
The ball carrier taken down at the 14-yard line. A three-yard gain on the play. Brings up third down.
After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports.
Ravens 3.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
I bet they thought they had picked that one up because it was a third and two call, and they got awfully close. Now we're at fourth and inches. I wonder if they think they're feeling lucky here and maybe want to go pick it up.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on fourth.
First down, Washington.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9. If you're going to run against this unit, especially down here, just beware. I mean, they're the top rushing defense in the league.
Yeah, and then they go ahead and they double down with the whole thing because you think, okay, let's throw the ball. Oh, yeah, that's right. They defend the pass pretty well, too. Very difficult task right now.
He pushes forward from maybe 3 down to the 6 yard line. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run pass option.
You get the sense? The next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. He lost 2, and it brings up 4.
On for the field goal. A 25-yard attempt.
This is a touchdown now at 10-3. So they get 3, certainly hoping for 6 after a 13-play drive.
So you console yourself on defense by saying you did your job, right? If they go 13 plays, you only give up a field goal. You did a nice job there. But here's the other part. 13 plays, you don't force any mistakes. You don't take the ball away. Maybe that's the way they should look at it.
First and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Just a lone field goal for them so far, trailing 10-3 as they come up first and 10. The drive will begin with a run by Edwards-Helaire. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Brings up second and 12 at the 19-yard line.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Now it's Jackson. They'll roll him out right. His throw incomplete.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
4 minutes to play here in quarter number 2. On third down, Jackson. And incomplete. They tried to drop it off, but he couldn't hold on. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down.
In punt formation.
Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. This is Harris. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt.
And it will be Washington football now with a first and 10.
28-yard line.
out there setting ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for three.
But you got to like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side.
Maybe a little gas, right?
Yeah, a little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting upfield and giving up three. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
Now they try the right side here. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Yikes, a 4-yard loss really sets him back now for second down. They go play action with Taylor. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
A gain of 6 yards.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion and would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
And he took the contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete. So on fourth down, Washington going to call on Tress Way to punt it away. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And just a 30-yard punt that time. And the Ravens, they'll take over.
At their own 27-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. We'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher third down looming. From the gun, Jackson. He'll find his running back, Edwards-Helaire. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It's a pickup of 11 and a Baltimore first down.
First and 10 at the 38-yard line.
To throw is Jackson. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
6 DBs on the field for Washington on third down. This time, Jackson will throw it. Dancing to his left. And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down. Here's Jordan Berry now as he'll kick it away for the second time. Fumble. 31 yards on the punt there. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And you're under a minute to go here in the half. Field position not really in your favor, but still time to try and move the ball and get in field goal range.
Yeah, you've got the lead. It's definitely a thought. Let's go ahead and try and increase it. But at the same time, I don't like the odds. I don't like where they are in the field. Got the lead. They've done well in the first half. Don't mess it up and go into halftime looking at each other wondering what if.
Complete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Throwing again, Taylor. And going deep for Hill. And this is caught at the 20. Touchdown, Washington. As the first half is winding down. And Washington able to come up with a quick strike touchdown.
Partner, to me, that touchdown had something that was kind of rooted in that group seeing the future. And what I mean by that is they had a plan. Let's find a way to score right here before the half. And that'll give us momentum going into the second half. Give us that cushion that we're looking for. They got that accomplished, scoring right before the half ended.
And he knocks it through.
Makes this Washington 17, Ravens 3.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away from the 6. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And he cannot avoid the pressure as the Washington pass rush gets home.
Brought down back at the 19.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. So we have come to halftime in what's already a 2-touchdown game. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The Ravens set to receive the football, trailing here as we resume action in the third quarter. From the 10, the lane opens here. He's past the 30. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return.
They're on 31-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. Second half starts with a run by Edwards-Helaire. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. They'll run. It's Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to be down at the 35. Gain of 7.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage,
They almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Throwing is Jackson. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. They were ahead of schedule after the gain of seven on first down, but the defense does not budge on second and third.
A 53-yard.
Gonzalez's kick is good. And a second field goal here gets him back with an 11 now. It's 17-6. So a good drive there to begin quarter number three, but they're only able to shave 3 points off the lead.
Well, something's better than nothing, all right? They didn't play particularly well in the first half, but they definitely need them to step on the accelerator now and play a whole lot better.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
The third quarter has not been kind to them. After they built that lead at intermission, they've seen that lead shrink.
And how much of that is simply execution? How much of that is maybe you lose your edge a little bit because you've got a lead? And you do have to credit the other team some because they've made some adjustments to start to slow them down. Can they find those counters now, those extra plays or plays they haven't run that'll be effective and get them back moving again?
They'll be looking for something here, anything to seize that momentum back. Now a handoff looking right. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. It's Taylor taking a deep shot here for Hardman. This is intercepted. Picked off at the 28. And the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line.
The Ravens take over.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Right now, officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Second and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. And now after the delay of game, they're operating behind the sticks, second and 15. Operating from the gun, Jackson. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting frustrated. Here we are into the third quarter, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync, Thus far, that hasn't happened. They're looking for answers both on the sidelines and in the huddle looking at each other.
And the Washington pressure gets to him. He will go down. Chase Young with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of seven.
Here's Jordan Berry now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Harris now to return.
So a good punt, but a solid 12-yard return.
And the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
At their own
out there, set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
They had that first half lead, but they have been shut down here in this third quarter, so time to retool a bit.
And probably need to tap into that emotional vein that gets them back to really playing hard and effectively. Because a lot of times we think it's just play calls and this isn't working and they're shutting them down. Sometimes when you get a lead, you lose your edge. You don't play quite as hard. That's what they're looking for here.
Trying to get that edge back as they've watched this lead shrink a little. Second and seven. Taylor gets this one to Hill. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
15 yards on the play. First down. And he has now hit number 500. Charles, that is his 500th NFL career catch.
Definitely worthy of applause, but I remember when 500 meant you were going to the Hall of Fame. Nowadays, in today's football, 500 puts you on the path. A significant number.
And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
48-yard line.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And across midfield he goes into Raven territory. It'll be a gain of five on the play, and it'll also be the final play of this third quarter.
Back now in Baltimore. It's Washington with the football and the lead as we start the fourth.
Raven six.
Washington on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and four.
From the gun, Taylor. That'll be complete to Breida. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. Give him 32 on the play.
He was not the primary target. They expected to get the ball downfield. Instead, checked it down. An old coach of mine used to say to us all the time, when they check it down, that should end the down. In this case, though, he foiled that in a big way and turned it into a big play.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. A great effort there. His first touchdown on the year.
And Washington going to add on to their lead.
Pinheiro now to add the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now.
Makes this Washington 24, Ravens 6.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
Taken in at the 3. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
Defensively, you said coming in earlier in the broadcast, the magic number was 20 points for you. That's what you thought they would have to hold this offense to, or less than that. And wow, they've done that in a big way, haven't they?
Not only have they done it, they put themselves in a great position to win this one because holding them down was paramount. If they could get it done, well, guess what? We see the end result. Right now, they have their eye on victory.
And leading here in the fourth. Problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay.
never nothing, you're labeled impatient. But once the boss made it, you're labeled amazing.
Now Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. They'll run here with Edwards-Helaire. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. He lost six there on the first down play.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
Now on second and 16, Jackson. And his throw is incomplete. Good coverage that time by Derwin James.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
The Ravens on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This is third and 16. And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. Forced out to his left. Looking left side, Andrews with it complete. And all the way down to the 29. A big time third down play for the Ravens. And even 50 yards. So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. That's going to be caught. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Zane Gonzalez on for the extra point. Second miss of the year, and our score will stay right where it is.
Zane Gonzalez set to kick off.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And he returns this to the 22.
Washington takes over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
2 yards the loss, second and 12. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. It's Taylor. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3. So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. Taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. And they get 17 more on that one and another first down. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
Washington.
On first down, here's Breida. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
Taken down.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
Now they'll throw with Taylor. This one complete to Mecole Hardman. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone, and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Now we've got whistles here before the snap, and I believe this is going to be on Washington. So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, third and long.
They go play action now. Taylor. He's got his man. That's Hardman. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
And that's how you throw for a whole heap of yards in a game. You get efforts like that from your receivers. How about him laying out for that catch?
Yeah, excellent. Makes a quarterback look a whole lot better. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Able to stay in bounds, and the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it to football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Call it a gain of four there, so it sets up a big play here. Third and a yard.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. And when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And they'll try and run the option to pick it up. And he is into the end zone for a Washington quarterback. His third touchdown now on the year. And Washington able to stretch that lead out even further. And that one makes this a 19-point game.
Makes this Washington 31, Ravens 12.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
Take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. And this,
a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off at the 46, and he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
After the interception, here's Taylor. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Finally, a good play there defensively on the deep ball. The secondary has had its struggles this entire game. Offensively, they've had their way with them.
Second and 10, it's Taylor again. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
An incomplete pass on second down. That muddles things a little bit here. This is third and 10. And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. And going deep for Hill. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Washington.
And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Brings up
National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you prime the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So for Washington, the win moves them up to 5-2 now on the year. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for the Ravens, they drop just their second game so far as they fall to 5-2. And they'll look to get back in the winning column next week as they head to Philly to face off with the Eagles. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.